Dale, what are you doing? You're feeding his addiction.
It all started in my junior year of high school. Every day, I would hop on Fortnite, but at a certain point, none of my friends were online. They all had jobs. Every day, they were always telling me, oh my gosh, my job sucks, this sucks, oh my gosh. But they were making money. They were doing something with their life, and I realized I also had to grow up. But I'm not gonna go work a job because they're telling me this sucks, this sucks, this sucks. Nah, that's dire. So I go online, I look up best businesses to start for teenagers. And they got this huge list and it's all this crazy stuff. Oh, make websites for people. Oh, mold their lawns and do all this thing like copywriting, all this stuff. I'm like, bro, what even is this stuff? And I have no idea what I'm about to do. And I remember one day I'm driving to school and we have this highway right outside of our school. We're driving like 40, 50, 60 miles, right? But for some reason, you're always gonna see kids standing on the side of the road, literally in middle school. We see this middle school kid, he's looking left and right, left and right. There's a clearing, he just sprints across. Bro risks his life to cross the street. Why? I keep seeing kids doing this every day. Why? It's because on the other side of that street was Dollar Tree. All of these kids from my school, every day, they're risking their life for candy. At that moment, it clicks into my mind. It's time to sell candy, start that candy cartel, bro. So I hit YouTube, right? I'm looking up how to sell candy. This dude, Poppy Chulo TV, this Mexican guy, literally Candy Cartel was in his bio, right? I'm like, this is the guy I need to learn from. I'm watching all his videos. He got an educational guy breaking it down step by step. Okay, you need this product. You need to sell for this price. You get it from these stores. I'm literally, all right, bet. I'm taking notes, literally everything. I bring my brother. We go to the store. We buy it. We buy exactly what we need, right? And we're all ready.
So the night before, we're packing our stuff up. We got our chips in these cinch bags, right? And we had them stacked accordingly in the most optimal way to store the most chips. And then we had our candy bags. We had like Skittles. I think we had Jolly Ranchers too. So we had our bags all packed and we were so excited. We were like, all right, we're about to make so much money, right? So the next day in the car, we put our bags in the back and we're plotting. We're like, yo, let's do it. We're ready.
Make so much money. Yes, sir.
And my mom goes, no, you're not gonna sell candy. And we're like, why? What's wrong with it? She's like, no, it's illegal. You're not supposed to be doing that. It's bad. So me, I'm a freshman at that time. Dale's a junior. So I'm just like, damn, you know what? Maybe she's right. Maybe I shouldn't do this. But Dale is a hero. And Dale was like, you know what? I'm gonna do this anyway. So as he gets out, he grabs his candy bags and his chip bags and he goes into the school. I remember sitting in class. I'm just chilling there. And I get a text from my phone in the group chat. My mom sends an article that says, candy seller gets arrested in his school after making like $5,000. I'm like, what the heck, bro? No way she's committed. No way she found an article, bro. So then I come back, when we get picked up, Dale's like, yo, I made so much money, bro. I sold it all. I was like, yo. So that was the first day. And from then on, we became candy sellers.
Every day, we packed our bags in the morning. It was low-key nostalgic, bro. Every day, we had these huge bags.
And originally, we had those tiny cinch bags because we didn't want to get caught because we thought it was, like, illegal. But as we got more established, we had these giant bags, which were very noticeable. But, like, nobody really said anything, you know what I'm saying? Like, I swear, at one point, I had a chip bag over my shoulder. I had a cooler full of Gatorade. And I had a giant duffel bag full of candy. Like, I was in some armored juggernaut from Call of Duty, bro. I was like,
So now let's get to the selling part. Bro, I remember like the first time, bro, like I immediately learned how it works. When you show them the candy, their eyes light up. Like you can literally see the dopamine like releasing into their brain. The decision, okay, I gotta buy this. This is gonna make my life better, bro. I can literally see it. All you gotta do, I didn't have the same thing. Hey, wanna buy candy? No, that's kind of sus. Like, hey, wanna buy some candy? No, that's not right. Show them the candy. Yo, I'm selling candy, bro. Yo.
These colors, right? These businesses are smart. They optimize these colors to get attention. They got the bright reds on the Skittles, the purples. So they're all optimized to get people's attention, right? So we didn't even have to do anything. What I learned was instead of just walking around with the bags, I had to open it, right? And I'd walk and I'd do it in a way where I show them, they kind of get a glimpse. They go, hey, you guys want to buy anything? They're like, yes, take my money, bro.
And I'm not gonna lie, bro. I think we got some kids addicted to candy, like straight up. Like I remember one time, one of my number one fan, my number one customer, right? One day he straight up bought $20 worth of candy. $20. I was like, AW, right? But his friends, they're like, yo, Dale, what are you doing? You're feeding his addiction. $20, bro. What is wrong with you?
with you?
And I look at his friends. I'm like, bro, if he's not buying it from me, he's getting it somewhere else. You know what I'm saying, bro? Like, if he's gonna spend the money, like, I might as well get it. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's enough. We low-key like created lifelong like sugar addictions. Like we're literally causing obesity and heart attack. This is the guilt that we have to live with every day, bro.
It was calm though. He got paid.
As the business continued on, bro, it just became so fun. It literally became like our purpose in lives. Like every day we're waking up, let's go. It was also really good to meet new people, improve my social skills, because I had to like really push myself to approach it. Oh man, I don't know them. Nah, I'm trying to make some money. Yes sir, you know what I'm saying?
And a big reason why this business model worked was because the vending machines were shut down. I think some like law by like Michelle Obama or something. So there was one day where we took a picture in front of the empty vending machine. And mugged it.
El Bozo.
I'll put it up.
We got so much money, I didn't even count. I was like a terrible accountant. Like I literally, like I had like all these ones. They're all like crumpled up. I just threw it in my drawer. So whenever I opened it up, I just saw a huge, like I could literally swim in the money. Cause like, that's what it was. Bro, I'm not about to sit there every day and be like, okay, I made this one sale. I sold one Skittle. Like that's way too much work, bro.
I'm different. I like counting my money, bro. My biggest days, I made like 90 bucks, 80 bucks a day.
As we started to sell more candy, like we got a lot of respect from people. I would say especially from like black kids as well. Cause like we're like being a good example, like just building a business, like hustling, like working hard and stuff like that. They really respected
legally.
That. Legally. Yeah, legally, right?
I'm gonna tell you guys the story of how I got robbed. All right, so like Dale said, people used to swarm around us, right? So it's really hectic. And Dale was the owner of the Cash App account. I did not have the Cash App account or password. So my system was, if people paid via Cash App, they would just show me that the transaction went through. And I was like, okay, cool. There's this one kid in particular. I gotta say, this guy is really smart, right? I respect it. What he figured out was, I don't have the password. I don't check if it's a new transaction. So if he just showed me a screenshot of him paying once, then he could just get infinite candy, right? So he paid $6 one time and he showed me the actual transaction. I was like, okay, cool. The next day, he bought something again for $6. And I was like, okay, cool. But he showed the screenshot of yesterday's transaction. The third day, he was really sus about it. He said, okay, I want this thing. This is exactly $6, right? And I was like, because I remember he bought something for $6 2 days before. So I remember, I was like, okay, yeah, it's $6. He showed me the screenshot. I was like, all right, wait till I get home. So I went home. I was like, Dale, pull up the Cash App transaction history. This kid did not send any money for 3 days and he was buying hella candy. I don't know. He did it for more than 3 days. He did it for multiple days. So I was like, all right, bro, it's time. So I had to, I called my boy. We're calling Paulie. I was like, yo, hey, Paulie, we got some issues. We gotta go debt collect, get somebody whacked. He was like, all right. So my boy is like, he's like 6 feet tall. I'm like 5'4 at this time. I'm 5'4, not that big. So I was like, all right, I need some help. So I called my boy. We're like, all right, we gotta go press this guy. We found out where his Spanish class is right after lunch. So we were like, all right, let's go. So we go to his Spanish class. I know the teacher. She's like, hey, hi, Ken, how you doing? I had her before in like middle school. I was like, hey, how you doing? I just gotta go talk to somebody real quick. We lock in, we go to the back. We're like, hey, I know what you've been doing. I know you've been showing screenshots and not actually paying for anything. It's like, what? What are you talking about? And I was like, bro, I know what you've been doing. Pay up. You owe me like $15. So he pulls out his Cash App. He's like, bro. And he starts typing. And he sends it. I might bet. Don't ever do this again. That's my most gangster moment.
Now, the teachers were actually pretty calm. Like, most teachers did not care because it was kind of like this weird vibe where it's like, you know, you're not supposed to do this, but like, bro, we don't care.
Nothing,
like, you know,
nothing's happening. You're not hurting anybody. No one's dying.
Yeah.
We like you guys. You guys are good students, stuff like that. Like, we're really good with the principal and all people of power, you know, because we've been there for years. We've been there since kindergarten and we're smart, been in the spelling bees, all these things.
Yeah, we had some good reputation, right?
Yeah.
But then there were these, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're just those one teachers. We just gotta like go the extra mile. You know what I'm saying? Like that's what they were hired to do.
They love their job.
The school was really smart because they specifically went out to find people who hate children. You'd be perfect for this job, bro. Like that's actually W hiring from the school's part, right? So, bro, I remember the hall monitor, right? Bro, 7'10", bro, like this like lanky dude, like bro, like if he was chasing after you, it was like the Slender Man, bro. Like, it was crazy, right?
And he always carried this like this camel bag with water in it, so he could be efficient, bro. Hey!
Chasing after kids like bro, out of class.
Running shoes in his athletic pants so we could run at the most optimal speed.
That sounds mad fun. Like just chasing kids around every day, ringing them on the neck. Get to class! Like that's looking mad fun, bro.
That was his whole job.
So one day, bro, I'm just walking, right? And then for some reason, bro, all the kids just disappear and it's just me alone in the hallway. And then I hear, Mr. Culver, Mr. Culver. I'm like, what the heck? I turn around, right? And then there he is standing there down the hallway, mad intimidating. Nah, bro, not intimidating at all. I got my huge, like sports bag with me. He's like, oh, you're on the sports teams, are you? Huh, huh, huh. What's in the bag? And I'm like, all right, bro. I've been selling candy literally every day. Bro knows exactly what is in the bag. He's trying to catch me lacking, bro. So obviously, I'm not about to fold. I'm like, candy.
Oh. I appreciate the honesty, but... you know you're not supposed to be doing that, right?
And in my mind, I'm thinking, like, are you gonna stop me? Cause like, like if not, I'm gonna keep selling, bro. Like, what the heck? I should have just like walked away. Like, what timing is bro on right now?
That was crazy. He did the exact same thing to me. I don't remember my story.
Bro was trying to find the weak link, bro.
I just remember he said the same thing. I went home. I used to be a rapper. I wrote a bar. I said, I be selling Skittles, gotta watch out for the narcs. Exactly about him, bro.
There was a dark period where we ended up getting addicted to our candy. That'll be our next video. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.